Hello friends, a very good day to all of you. Today I am going to discuss the functions of money. In the last session I had discussed the characteristics of money. So what can be the functions of money? That I am going to discuss today in detail. So the basic functions of money is to facilitate the exchange of goods and services, to lessen the time and efforts required to carry on trade. Barter system involves huge wastage of time and money as well as the effort. A modern economy with a lot of experience among various sectors cannot be run without money. So the basic function of money is helpful in exchanging of goods and services, which reduces the time and efforts to carry on the trading activity. And the money system also involves the less wastage of time and effort, whereas the barter system involves a huge wastage of time and effort while doing the transactions of goods and services. So with respect to modern economy, it involves a number of functions that can be smoothly function within a society, and without money none of the business activity can perform in a society. So following can be the functions that can be broadly classified into two types. First is primary function and second one is secondary function. Primary function can also be termed as main or basic function, whereas secondary function is also termed as subsidiary or derivative function. As it is known as derivative function because it is derived from the primary function. Now, the function of money can further be divided into following two types. Under primary function, following are the main two functions of money. First is medium of exchange, and another primary function is measure of money or measure of value. Whereas secondary function involves standard of deferred payments and store of value. Now I am going to discuss all these four functions in detail one by one. The first function is the primary function, and the primary function includes the most important function of money which must perform in every country. And the first primary function is the medium of exchange. So money as a medium of exchange can be served by anything that is generally acceptable by people in exchange for goods and services. And the fact that money is often referred to as generalized purchasing power, which emphasizes the freedom of choice that the use of money affords. And the owner of goods and services need not secure their supplies from the people to whom they are trading. So those goods and services, they can use their money to buy the things which they wish, they want most from the people who offer the best bargain and at the time they consider the most advantageous. So money as a medium of exchange means that can be used to make payments for all transactions of goods and services. And this function has removed the major difficulty of lack of double coincidence of wants and inconveniences associated with the barter system. So the major difficulties which we were facing in barter system, the major function of medium of exchange has removed that difficulty, and the use of money allow purchase and sale to be conducted independently of one another. And this function also facilitates the trading with the help of transactions in an economy. And it has no power to satisfy human wants, but it commands power to purchase those things which have utility to satisfy human want. Now, the another function or the primary function of money is the measure of value. Money as a measure of value means that money works as a common denomination in which values of all goods and services are expressed. As a measure of value, we can say by reducing the value of all goods and services to a single unit, that is price, it becomes very easy to find out the exchange ratios between them and comparing their prices. This function facilitates maintenance of business accounts, which would be otherwise impossible. And it also helps in calculating relative prices of goods and services. And due to this reason, it is regarded as a unit of account. Because the monetary unit serves as a unit in terms of which values of all goods and services is measured and expressed. So, like in India, rupee is regarded as a unit of account. In England, pound is regarded as a measure of or unit of account, and so on. Now, talking about the secondary function of money, as these refers to those functions of money which are supplementary to the primary function, and these functions are derived from the primary functions, therefore they are also known as derivative function. So the first secondary function of money is a standard of deferred payment. So money also serves as a standard or unit in terms of which deferred or future payments are stated, and this appeals to the payments of interest, rents, salaries, pensions that can be paid in some future specified date. So every day millions of transactions take place in which payments are not made immediately, and money encourages such transactions and helps in capital formation and economic development of a country. So this money as a standard of deferred payment can be used to pay the certain amount in some future specified date. And this secondary function of money is significant because money as a standard of deferred payment has simplified the borrowing and lending operations. It also led to the creation of financial institutions. Now, talking about the another secondary function of money is the store of value. As money also serves as a store of value, that means it can use to transfer purchasing power from present to future. And money is a way to store wealth. Although wealth can be stored in other form also, but money is the most economical and convenient way. It provides securities to individuals to meet contingencies, unpredictable emergencies, and to pay future debts. So under barter system, it was very difficult to use goods as a store of wealth because of perishable nature of some goods and high cost of storage. So money as a medium of exchange, it holds twofold manner. First is to use of money as a medium of exchange decomposes a single barter transaction into two separate transactions of purchase and sale. And this will require that the medium of exchange also serve as a store of value. As money not only store a value, we have other assets of all kinds that too serve as a store of value and compete with money in this capacity. But money alone is perfectly liquid store of value. So thank you everyone. That's all for today. We had discussed the two main functions of money, primary function and secondary function. Under primary function, we had discussed money as a medium of exchange, money as a unit of account, and under secondary function, we had discussed money as a standard of deferred payment or as a store of value. Thank you everyone. That's all for today. Have a nice day.